Simon from What Culture here, and we have just seen Clash of Champions, and man, did a lot go down. We saw some dirty finishes, and then we saw some more dirty finishes, and then we saw some more dirty finishes, and then a man almost died. So that was nice. But there's only one thing that matters when it comes to the new era of Raw's first ever pay-per-view. Was it any good? And that's why we're here to up the ups and down the downs on Clash of the Champions. So let's do just that. Let's start all fiery and aggressive, just like Gallows and Anderson did in their match with the New Day. That was awesome, that was great, and that was an up. Seeing the club just run at the tag champs at the start of the match was the best. They came across like a genuine threat, and straight away you start to think, oh man, this could be their time, they're gonna do it. However, what was more of a down was how the New Day actually retained their tag team titles. I'm not entirely sure it's that bad. I mean, in 2016, what is a babyface and what is a heel? But the New Day, the good guys, cheated to win. Xavier Woods smashing Francesca II into Anderson's face not only meant the finish wasn't clean, but it meant that they cheated, so New Day are cheats. There's a story to be told here, and it should be one that sees the New Day change it up a little bit, get a bit more serious, a bit more edgy. But it won't, and I bet the story goes nowhere, and this was just a way to extend the feud so we can keep seeing Gallows and Anderson versus the New Day until the New Day beat the tag team title record, then Gallows and Anderson can win it, and then the New Day will probably win it back. Still, the match was good though, but all that stuff was a down. It was nice to see the Cruiserweights back on a pay-per-view though. It's been almost 10 years since that happened, and TJ Perkins and Brian Kendrick did a great job in changing the pace and bringing a different flavour to the show. It wasn't the best match the two could have had, but they had a nice back and forth, and Kendrick attacking Perkins after the match means this feud can keep going. If we get a nice story out of it, Cruiserweights become important, we want to see the Cruiserweights, everybody likes the Cruiserweights, doesn't it? Is Cesaro dead? Because if he's not dead, he most definitely should be dead. The Swiss Superman planted his face into the mat after a suicide dive during Clash of Champions, and it was so bad, if you haven't seen it, just think of the worst thing you can think about, times that by 10, and that's what it was like. The mat where he hit will probably have a face imprint of Cesaro until the end of time. I mean, it's an up because he's still alive, but it's a down because we never, ever, ever want to see stuff like that again. It was madness. Thankfully, the match itself was very good. Regardless what you thought about each individual bout, knowing this was the last one and it was the final of the series, gave it drama and gave it tension. You wanted to know who was going to win. And Cesaro sold great throughout the match, even before he tried to kill himself. So that's an up. The result though, a down. I'm sure there's going to be a reason as to why WWE decided to make this series a tie, but sometimes you just gotta give the people what they want. It's like when you go to a movie. Half the time you know exactly where that movie's gonna go, but you sit down, you eat your popcorn, and you go along for the ride. You don't care you know the outcome. So going all this way and not having a winner? That's like being in the cinema and halfway through your movie, the usher comes in and just sweeps you out of the room. Go on, get out of here. We don't want you. That's not nice. They should have wrapped things up. Chris Jericho is best, so him beating Sami Zayn is up. With that said, what does WWE do with Sami Zayn now? I mean, events later on justify why Jericho won, and we'll get to that in a bit, but just look at Zayn's recent track record. He loses all the time, and now he's lost again. He always performs well, and you can't help but get behind the guy, but he never wins. If you go through individual matches or feuds, he always comes up on the losing end. Literally, always. If that's his role in WWE, then fine, but the man is capable of so much more than that, and I'm worried if we continue to go down this path, there'll be no coming back from it. Great codebreaker sell though, but still, that's a down. I like the women's match. Great ideas, great tension, great drama. It's good, and an up. Charlotte especially is just awesome. That heel persona she's got going on just gets better and better by the week, and I'm not bored of it at all. In fact, I want to see where it's going to go, and when she puts all that stuff in a match, I love it. On top of that, you see that double moonsault? That's pretty damn good. And the finish coming from a big boot gave you the, oh, I didn't see that coming moment, and I like those moments. We need Sasha Banks' character to go through some sort of transformation soon, and as for Bayley losing again, well, Still though, great stuff. Rusev lost, and Rusev lost his championship. Down, 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 down. But There is a smart logic to this. You cannot put Roman Reigns back in the main event scene at the moment. People hate him, they love to boo him, and it's almost become comical. You've got to change tack, and hopefully, this is that tech. Forget the fact that this should have been Reigns' original plan. You know, put him in a good upper mid-card feud, let him win a belt that's not the world title, get the fans behind him. Seeing him with this US title is gonna be good. The man is, you'll have to forgive me, extremely talented. He's just really, 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 really hated. And he's hated so much that the big bad Russian-Bulgarian dude got cheered. We're sure to get at least one more match between Reigns and Rusev, and that's not a bad thing. The two work well together. And if WWE treats this right, it could be good. All round. Maybe. Up. The same can be said for Kevin Owens and Seth Rollins, who tore it up in the main event as only they know how to do. What a couple of talented performers, a massive up. This was only helped when Chris Jericho swanned down to ringside, and while that did make the outcome pretty obvious, the banter between Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens was brilliant. The two really are best friends. It may paint Owens as the I can't win without help champion, but therein lies the point. If you keep building this stuff with Jericho and then Owens turns on Jericho, you've got a ready-made storyline there to go. The veteran dude going after one more championship run after he was screwed over. I'd buy into that, and that's why it makes sense that Jericho beat Zayn earlier in the night. If that's where you're going, you gotta keep the man strong. We do have to throw one final down in there though, because there were a lot of dirty finishes at Clash of Champions, and I do not like being dirty. Tag team match, dirty. Best of seven series, dirty. Universal Championship match, dirty. It is all right sometimes, WWE, just to have out and out winners. We'll buy into that, we'll love it. We can understand that one guy won and one guy lost and we'll move forth. That's okay. Also, although I'm sure it's leading to a big turn down the line, we didn't need to see Stephanie McMahon in the main event. We'd had enough shenanigans by that point. So, Clash of Champions. Pretty good show all in all, and overall, it did what it set out to do. Well, aside from give us a winner between Cesaro and Sheamus, but what are you going to do? It's a bit nuts that we have another pay-per-view already in 2 weeks, and that's no mercy, so hopefully we won't start getting worn down. But right now, Clash of Champions, Backlash, good job WWE, I'm going to give you two thumbs up. That's because I don't have any more thumbs, so it's pretty much the best you can get. Now don't forget to drop us a comment below and let us know what you thought about Clash of Champions, and then like, share, and subscribe. You can even go to whatculture.com and read the ups and downs article that this whole thing was based on. And they've got different opinions to me, so you can get all mad at them as well. Also, I'm on Twitter at SimonMiller316. So much promotion. I'm Simon from What Culture, and I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. I think I actually love Chris Jericho. Like physically love him. He is most definitely the GOAT.
Do you want to see WCPW live but are allergic to the awful people of Newcastle? WCPW is coming to Greater Manchester on Saturday the 8th of October to the Altrincham Silver Blades Arena. Your ticket won't just get you a stat card featuring Cody Rhodes versus Kurt Angle, but will also grant you access to our first ever fan convention during the day. Meet the What Culture guys, have photos with your favourite WCPW wrestlers, a host of other surprises, and VIP members will get to meet Kurt Angle and Cody Rhodes in person. Tickets can be bought at wc.pw.